Those who were cast
they have a testimony. Those
who are troubled,
they will not sleep.
And as all their life was going, people were restored life.
Those
who were saved in Bala and have come here,
put up.
You can see those who are
here.
We are a gathering for those who have gone and saved. This is not for the new
believers.
This is for the elders. So those who have done a great
work,
spreading the gospel to all other areas. But we have not denied them to come. To come to be with us.
Praise
our Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Are we together? I want to tell you
that
the Lord does not segregate among his people. He sends whomsoever he desires. He takes charge of heaven and earth. Praise the Lord Jesus. The book of Acts.
There
was a time when God appeared to Peter. A white sheet descended.
The
images of all animals. And
a
voice told to Peter, slaughter and eat.
Pedro,
Peter said, no.
This is abominable. God doesn't allow this.
Mukama takiri zechu. And the red sheet was.
And
the Lord brought it again. It had all the animals, all kinds of animals, pigs,
camels,
cows, and many other animals. And
a
voice told Peter, slaughter and eat. Peter saw that was impossible. And that is the Lord was changing. In not eating those animals, the Israelites, because they were not eating those animals, the Israelites never
moved
from doing the things that annoyed God. In taking care of the
Sabbath,
it never had to argue against God. Those circumcisions, praise our Lord, it never helped them. But the most important thing was righteousness. That's what the Lord would help somebody. So when the Lord changes the
Lord,
he said, Peter, slaughter and eat. Three times, Peter resisted. And the Lord said, okay. He was not among the 12 tribes of Israel. When the Lord spoke to Cornelius, he said, his servants to Peter. God inviting Peter to come and
but
when they were going, Peter in his vision. The Lord told him there are people who are
coming.
But what they tell you, please do.
He
moved with the servant up to Cornelius, up to the house of Cornelius. He saw that God
had
spoken with the Israelites. Those Gentiles who were not Israelites. Israelites, you know, when Israel. And when Peter left there and went to Israel, Israelites decided to add a
garrison.
If you go to verse 11, we are not going to read because of time. Praise our Lord Jesus. They argued with him. And Peter said, my dear,
we
were given a spirit like we were given. You cannot deny that. Because what we were given, that is what they were given. That's where we got a blessing.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Amen.
God belongs to all tribes.
That
much more so. You righteous people in the entire world. What does it say, verse 34?
Agamba Awo Petero na yasami akamake na agamba nti mazima ntegete nga Katonda tasosola mu bantu. Naye mu ggwanga lyonna lyonna amutya n'akola obutuukirivu
amukiriza. What is it that makes a man to be holy or righteous? What is it that you ought to do and then you are counted holy? Others think
that
if you go and cleanse your body, you are therefore you are holy. Maybe somebody is dead and you get to an oil. I'm anointed.
That's all you to say.
They can
increase,
oh, purify or holify the
grace.
Others know that when somebody dies, they will pray for that person. Righteousness is performed and is for the living people. That's why in Genesis chapter
6,
when the world continued to expire and
not,
the children of God
desired
and they did abominable
things.
They annoyed God and the Lord regretted as to why he made a human being. Why
is so?
As you live holiness, you do things that annoy God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So
in that kind of
action,
when people
man,
Genesis chapter 6,
so
must read back up
to verse 5. And they never spare anything like
a woman.
Whenever they see a woman,
you
see something of gain. See that you've got a business. See that you are going to be a man. And men are not going to be contented with the ladies. That kind of lust came from
God.
And that's what brought the floods here on earth. That is the sin. The second sin. That is abominable. That was done. When the first sin, when Adam left the voice of the Lord, he gave birth to a child. The child called Cain. Cain was of anger. And he killed his brother. That was a terrible sin after the children of men.
Elamu kusoka gana mateka kade kumite gani.
At the beginning, the Ten Commandments were
not done. Mkama amani ya kolo mtu.
The Lord knew that he made man
Mutifananiji.
In his image.
Kwa kumusa nyusa.
Yeah, to please him.
Kwa kuma vitu yonna.
To take care of all
things.
In his creation.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mkama yega
zwe. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Mkwe kwa nini ya mwenye.
Hallelujah. God has lifted up a human being. He saw that for sure. He is above all
preachers.
To talk with him. To discuss with him. That
he
will keep this word in his nature. He trusted in human
being.
Let me see and the children of men. And that is fornication or adultery. The children of God, the children of God, saw the daughters of men that they were beautiful and they married whomever they
desired.
And the Lord said, okay, my spirit will not
add
to you.
Continue. Omoyo kwange chukua kwenenga na mtu we mirembe ne mirembe. Kubanga na yegwe mubili.
Oh yes.
Na ye na kuzezilibe miaka chukumi mwabili.
Walo.
Here.
Mukama kuyani.
When the Lord God annoyed.
Bobango sinye kubanga baso.
If you refer to the first place.
Kari wa male miaka mbikuni.
They will take thousands of years.
Bitano.
500 years.
Rusambu.
700 years.
Wenda wata.
900. People will live for long. And when the Lord God
annoyed,
he first cut short our years to 120 years. No matter whether the whites who are in the first
world,
not even their presidents, nobody can surpass 120 years. And they will lead a real good life. But the Lord God annoyed.
And
he designed the entire world. Let's call our brethren here to tell us.
And
tell
our
country, the elderly die at what age?
Please, you can stand up and respond to this question. So, I think it's a simple question for you. Our visitor.
We invited our visitor. That may be in the white country.
Sorry, you.
The elderly die at what age in your country?
Is it
80?
I am
80
years.
80 years.
Ngabo emyaka emyaka.
Even for them, 120 years is a myth. The Lord decided the entire world, whether you are rich, whether you are educated, whether you are the most wise, no matter what authority you have with the
God,
the Lord decided. What is in Uganda is what is in other nations. In education, they teach you about indicators of life, things that make somebody alive.
But they,
among the wise,
they die.
Even they also get miscarriages.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
The
Lord got annoyed.
Because
of a human being, to leave track.
So
that is the God we need to
fear.
He has the power to destroy a human being and to throw you to hell. He has the power to sustain you. The medics have tried to see to it that they try to start the every part of a human being, that somebody is alive. Others even transfer, but they die. They can get someone and take him to America,
or South Africa,
or South Africa, or in any other developed countries,
India.
They change your organs.
No matter
they change, whatever they do, the person is destined to die.
And
once you are above 120, you don't testify in court. The things you do, nobody affirms them.
Hey,
you are not a human being.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Programmatum.